Everyone, welcome to the wedding, okay, right? On a beautiful afternoon, right? It's been requested by the bride for everyone to put their cell phones away. Absolutely. They hired some professionals, they'll share the pictures, and appreciate it if you do that. And then lastly, wait for me to say stand for the bride, okay? That way we'll all stand at the same time. And welcome to the wedding and enjoy yourselves. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
for me to say stand, okay? Thank you. Everyone, please stand for Brandy. Everyone, please have a seat. Andrew and Brandy would like to thank you all for taking time from your busy lives and coming and sharing this very special moment and this very special life event with them. We are gathered today in the sight of God, family, and friends, all of you all, to join together Andrew, Mark, Peterman, and Brandy, Christine, Huey in loving and supportive matrimony. Who is here to give this woman away on her next journey in life?
We do.
Very nice. Oh, very nice.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Go ahead, give hugs and kisses there. Yeah. Yeah, good. All right, thank you. Thank you. Very nice. So come on, step up. We face each other. Hand your bouquet off. Mm-hmm. Is that how you wanted to have your dress lay? Mm-hmm. Right? We have to check with the bride with everything, right? Of course. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay. And, Brandy, because you just walked out here and you didn't see how beautiful it is in here, why don't you just take a look around on your wedding day? Doesn't she look beautiful, everyone?
Yes.
Okay, yeah? All right. You ready, sir?
Yeah, got
okay.
This. Got this.
Okay, excellent, all right. Marriage is not to be entered into unadvisedly or lightly, but reverently, deliberately, and with respect for God and each other. True marriage is more than joining the bonds of two people in just a word, marriage. In its right relation, it is the uniting of two souls already attuned to each other. When such a true bond already exists between two people in true love, it is fitting that an outer acknowledgement of love and commitment be made. We are here to bear witness to the entry into the closer relationship of husband and wife of these beloved friends who are already one in spirit. Andrew and Brandy, you are now taking into your care and keeping the happiness of the one person in all the world whom you love most. You are adding to your life not only the affection of each other, but also the companionship and blessing of deep trust. You are agreeing to share each other's strengths, responsibilities, and to share love unconditionally. Brandy and Andrew, we are here to remember and rejoice with you, to recount with one another that it is love, faith in each other, and open communication that guides us on our path, and to celebrate as you begin this journey together. It is in this spirit that you have come here today to exchange these vows of love, support, and understanding. So they both have written special words for each other that they're going to share with each other for their vows. And Andrew, go ahead and share your special words with Brandy.
My vows to Brandy. Brandy, I love you. You are my best friend. Today, I get to marry my best friend. I promise to encourage and inspire you, to laugh with you as much as possible so I can see that beautiful smile that I fell deeply in love with. I promise to always be by your side in times of sorrow and in struggle. I promise to love you now and forever, infinity and beyond, just like Buzz Lightyear. In good times and in bad times, when life seems easy and when it seems hard, I promise to cherish you and always hold you in highest regard. These things I give you today and all the days of our life.
My vows to Andrew. Andrew, today I take you as my husband, my best friend, my faithful partner, my favorite karaoke carpool person, and the love of my life from this day forward and beyond. Today, for the rest of my life, I offer you my solemn vow to be your partner for everything, including your nurse when you've got one of your infamous man colds.
It happens a lot.
I promise to love you unconditionally in good times and in bad. I ask that you be no other than yourself, loving what I know of you for as long as we both shall live. I promise to love and respect you with all that I am and with a passion that will never die. I promise to try my very hardest to be on time for things and not take and not take 90 minutes to get ready. P, I love you so much. You are everything I've ever wanted in a husband, and I know we will continue to encourage and inspire each other, to laugh at each other's jokes and stories, whether they're funny, embarrassing, or both. I promise to comfort you in times of sorrow and struggle. I promise to love you when life seems easy and when it seems hard, when our love is simple and when it is an effort. I promise to cherish you and to always hold you in highest regard, even on days when I wonder if you're 43. We're finally doing it, babe. I promise to give all of these things to you for all the days of our life. I love you.
I love you more.
Those were really nice to each other.
Thank you.
Yeah. Okay. So now we'll do the exchange of rings, okay? For thousands of years, lovers and couples have exchanged rings as a token of their vows. Compared to the love between you, Andrew, and you, Brandy, these rings are not of great value in themselves, but are made precious by your wearing of them. Your rings say that even in your uniqueness, you've chosen to be joined together in trust, respect, and love. Let these rings also be a sign that love is substance as well as soul, a present as well as a past, and that despite its occasional sorrows, love is a circle of happiness, wonder, delight, and support. Okay. All right. Thank you, sir. Mm-hmm. Okay, so you'll take that one. Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay, so, Andrew, look at your beautiful bride. And at the end of your statement, you'll place the ring on Brandy's finger, okay? Mm-hmm. Please repeat after me. Brandy, just as his circle is without end.
Brandy, just as the circle is without end.
My love and devotion for you is eternal.
My love and devotion for you is eternal.
I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my love.
As a symbol of my love.
And faithfulness.
And faithfulness.
As I place it on your finger.
As I place it on your finger.
I commit my heart and soul to you.
I commit my heart and my soul to you.
I ask you to wear this ring.
I ask you to wear this ring.
As a reminder of the vows.
As a reminder of the vows.
We have spoken today.
We have spoken today.
In the presence of our family and friends.
In the presence of our family and friends.
And with this ring.
And with this ring.
I gladly marry you.
I gladly marry you.
And join my life to yours.
And join my life to yours.
Thank you, sir. Mm-hmm. Okay, got it. Okay, Brandy. Look at your handsome groom. And please repeat after me. And at the end of this, your statement, place the ring on his finger, okay? Andrew, this ring is my promise.
Andrew, this ring is my promise.
To nourish our love.
To nourish our love.
And carefully tend it.
And carefully tend it.
To hope with you in sorrow.
To hope with you in sorrow.
And dance with you in joy.
And dance with you in joy.
With this ring.
With this ring.
I give you my heart.
I give you my heart.
I promise from this day forward.
I promise from this day forward.
You shall not walk alone.
You shall not walk alone.
May my heart be your shelter.
May my heart be your shelter.
And my arms be your home.
And my arms be your home.
Do they look good?
They look good.
She's been wanting to see that for a little while.
It's good that you did it. All right, so very good. So now comes the good part, okay? Andrew and Brandy, as your hands and hearts, as your hands and hearts are joined together now, so your lives, spirits, and future are also joined in a union of love, trust, and faithfulness. Above you are the stars, and below you is the earth. Like the stars, your love should be a constant source of light, and like the earth, a firm foundation from which to grow. Andrew and Brandy, the two of you have agreed to live together in matrimony, have promised your love for each other by these vows, the giving of these rings, and the joining of your hands. And with these statements, which we have just heard and witnessed before God and his company of family and friends, I now pronounce you husband and wife. You may now kiss the bride. And ladies and gentlemen, presenting for the first time, Mr. and Mrs. Andrew and Brandy Peterman!
Please go around applause. They will try to get deserved today. First, we're going to start with the parents. is not just on the pigs. Say You Won't Let Me Go by James Arthur.
Things here tonight. Remember, we're here under God's graces, so let's begin with a prayer. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Dear Lord, Heavenly Father, we have come this night together to celebrate the union of Brandy and Andrew. Their passion and love for each other is a reflection of the great love you have for all of us. We ask your blessings and graces upon this happy couple, that they may live their lives together in ways most pleasing to you, and that every effort of theirs in this union may work towards the fulfillment of your heavenly will. We thank you, Lord, for each and every blessing you give us on this good earth, of love and friendship, of life and sustenance, and most especially the intimate knowledge of you and your workings in this world. Protect us always, Lord. Protect and watch over us tonight as we partake in this bounty which comes from you, and as we make merry in celebration of the love of Brandy and Andrew. May we thank you for this food which we are about to receive. We ask and pray, Lord, that others not so fortunate, both in this community and in our home neighborhoods and across the world, may have enough to eat this night and all nights as well. We thank and ask for your blessings upon those who have put in their time and talents in preparing and serving both the marriage ceremony, and this meal. We ask your protection for those who leave this place over the coming days, Lord, as they make their travels back home, that their journeys, no matter how near or how far, may be made in safety. Lastly, Lord, on this joyous occasion, our hearts and minds are also turned to recognize that some family members are not present physically here, as over the years, some may have passed on from this life into the rewards of the next one. We ask you to turn your loving and merciful gaze upon our loved ones who have passed, that they may join you in your divine presence in heaven, and that we too, one day after this journey of life has ended, may be with them and you as well. We ask these things of you, Heavenly Father, through our Lord Jesus Christ, thy Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
You might not know me. My name is Victor. And I am Annie's older brother. All right, so now that I've introduced myself, we're going to go table by table, starting with table number one. You guys can just go ahead and stand up. Right, make sure you guys tip your servers and waiters on your own lucky hand. But seriously, in all seriousness, when these two guys get hitched, everyone here now is family. You know, there's not just Cobas or Hueys or Petermans or whichever other last name is out there. You guys are all one family. Okay? So let's give a big round of applause. I've been asked to give a speech here tonight, representing all the groomsmen. Big mistake. Big mistake. Andy and Brandon, take a big sigh of relief. So, no, I'm getting this way, it's really over. Andy, you have been lucked out big time. Brandon, it's over. Since we're all adults here, I guess I can say this. Grammy, you are finally a Peterman. Okay, so, but really, all those long days and months and, you know, weeks of planning and, you know, sweat and labor getting this all together, it's done. You can relax, enjoy the moment. Okay, just enjoy it. Ruminate every moment, you know, take it in. Enjoy everyone that's here to celebrate your night. All right? We may use the table here to throw them off, okay? Because I got like, you know, 13 pages of this. Just kidding. But anyways, yeah, this is it. This is your night. You guys are married. You are screwed, but you guys are married. Just kidding. You guys are Mr. and Mrs. You guys are all yours, so each to each other, okay? Now, we're going to move on to some memories first. These are memories and stories and little things that some of the other guys gave me to express tonight. So first, Georgie.
Me?
Yeah, Georgie. Georgie had all the nice things to say to both of you guys. However, for some reason, though, he couldn't just go into too much detail. Because, and I quote, he had no PG-13 stories about him. Only rated R and F. However, he did share a lot of funny little pictures. You know, Disney trips, keg stands, sleepovers and onesies with some very interesting paraphernalia on them, paint parties, the beach. Also, have you guys ever seen a grown man wearing a Spider-Man jersey and a red and blue tutu? That's Andy.
I have that picture.
Disney trip, but I guess food and wine festival many times. They go to themes, you know, Disney trips like that. So, yep, so that's Andy. Thank you, Jordan.
Yep.
All right. Alberto. Besides some interesting activities that happen late at night at Disney trips, or before Disney trips, I guess, you know, involving limited amounts of clothing. I'm not going to those two. But anyways, basically, he said that, Andy, you're an overachiever. And I guess you are taking care of their son, Mason. And, you know, like, he's a little kid, a little baby. Babies do interesting things with diapers. But apparently, Andy decided, well, one or two wipes was not enough. The entire, like, box of wipes had to go. So, good job, Andy. Nice. That's good. I'm sure he was at the end of it, like, what happened to the whole box of wipes? What about the next time? No? It's fine. Anyways, there's a lot of stories like that. But he also mentions a lot of more stories of drinks and Mickey Mouse. More to, you know, too much to go into, but so you know, kind of seeing the theme here. Next up is Danny. Danny remembers moving Andy and Brandy into the Miami Lakes apartment. At this point, however, he's mentioned some activities of an intimate nature related to cohabitation that I can't really go into. But regardless. It was nice having those experiences, but then he got to reconnect with Andy and Brandy when they moved to Fort Lauderdale, and now he's a big part of their Los Solos adventures. So that's very nice. All right, last of the groomsmen is Zach, over here. Zach had a lot of good memories to share as well, especially of some of PMB's first trip together to Ohio, to where the Copas resided. I guess a few years ago.
Yeah, a few years ago.
Andy loves the snow. He loved the snow when he went. And Zach remembers them going sledding on these $10 sleds, which quickly broke down, and then they moved on to what is termed as, and this is not my term, this is apparently what was being called by Mrs. Coba, ghetto sleds, which are made of cardboard, trash bags, and tape. They lasted 5 minutes. Carlos had a fun time in the snow. Apparently also Andy has another love, a secret love. One that apparently Andy almost cast Brandy off to the side for. Sheetz gas stations. Sheetz gas stations, ladies and gentlemen. These are apparently these mega gas stations, not in this neck of the woods, but they're like Wawa's, but better, apparently. Like super Wawa's. You can get subs, you can get salads, you can get mozzarella sticks. Apparently, are his favorite, so that's great. It's clear from Zach's stories that Andy truly loves his new family, which is great. So we're very happy to see that. What all these stories from all the groomsmen have in common is that that Andy has made a big impact on each and every one of them. And all of these memories are deeply treasured by all of them as well. Now, it's on to me. It's my turn. Brandy, did P ever take you to showings? No? Okay. That's interesting. Very interesting. An early memory of me, of mine is that our family, when maybe I was about 8, my brother was about 6, we were at showings. And this particular showman's had a burger, like a burger buffet. So basically, think of like the worst burger you could possibly ever imagine to us nowadays. But for us little kids, it was a dream. They were great burgers, apparently back. But anyways, he's there. You know, we're having lunch, and he says, you know what? I'm gonna take my special girl on our first date to Shoney's. Shoney's. Really? Shoney's?
It was in
there. It was in there, yes, yeah. You know, apparently has some really good specials, so you know, go to Shoney's. This was also the same lunch that Andy proclaimed out to the whole world that he also wanted to grow up and be a garbage truck driver. So, you know, Brandy, I guess because of the fact he never took me to Shoney's, it worked out. You know, so he's a police officer now instead of driving around picking people's garbage. Now, however, I guess he is picking up the garbage after all. So that's good. By the way, my wife helped me with these jokes. Now for some tips. And Brandy, if Andy ever acts up at dinner, just order his meal right up front. Because then you can have some nice quality time if, by just putting a nice napkin on top of his head, and he'll start snoring. And he'll sleep the entire rest of the dinner. Also, make sure you order some pium for him. Now, pium, for all of you folks, is spelled P-U-M-E. Pium. And in old Andrew, pium means chocolate chip cookie dough ice cream. Okay? Just so you guys know, that's the way that Andy's park is chocolate chip cookie dough ice cream. At least it used to be. Apparently he has other favorites now. So, what I'm getting at is, Andy and I, we're very close. He's very close to all of his groomsmen. Andy and I have shared a story or two. He's left a mark on me. One or two very important marks, like a bell thrown to the face that left a scar, which is part, slight the reason why I have facial hair. There's a bump on the side of my head from him throwing a plastic toy like sword at me when I was a little kid. We were roughhousing, out by the pool. Those many years ago, we had a lot of great experiences growing up together. And but now we're grown up, and we are writing stories of our own. I have my beautiful wife Courtney, and we live in New Jersey. And now Andy has my new sister, Brandy. So my advice to you both. It's not about each other. It's not about you or you. It's about both of you. You guys are together. Make every day, every goal of your day to how to best serve the other person. Not for yourself, but for the other person. As the Bible puts it, you have now become one flesh. You've left your old lives and cling to each other. Cling to each other, whichever way you want to put that, take that. But literally, cling to each other in the best moments and the worst moments. Because in the end, you're going to have each other. No matter what life throws at you, you're each other's. Okay? So always remember that. And lastly, Brandy, I see how he is around. He's as giddy as that little kid I always remember. However, I also see admiration. I see devotion. I see that spark that lights up in him every single time you guys are together. Guys, you gotta keep that flame high. Guys, that's the key. That and communication. Communicate. So important. Communication and keeping this day, this wedding day, alive in each other's hearts every single day. That's the key to, at least in my 6.5 years of experience, a good marriage. So keep it going, okay? And now, Andy, lastly. You may have people come up to you and say, I wish your dad was here, to see this. Other sentiments like that, some of them mixed with regret or whatnot. Listen, just remember, Bobby is here. Our dad is here. He's always been here. He will always be here, all right? He's proud of you, all right? He's proud of the man you have become, proud of the officer you have trained to be, and he's also proud of the husband that you will become now, all right? So I love you guys, and on behalf of all of us, we'll always be there for you, and we wish you all the best. All right, so let's go ahead. And stand up, let's give our first toast to Andy and Brandy.
Andy and Brandy!
Woo! Andy and Brandy! Alright, so I'm done talking. My 13 pages are up. I'm going to hand this over now to Drew. Yeah, it was just about 13, right? I'll have Drew come up and he's going to be the first to represent the bride's side of the family, right? Okay.
For those of you who haven't met me, my name is Andrew. I'm one of Frank's bridesmen. I'm sure for a lot of you that might be the first time you've ever seen a bridesman. But the thing is that the friendship between myself, Ryan, and Brandy has always been something of an oddity for a lot of people who are very used to it. But I did want to say that, you know, when I look at you guys, I'm always reminded of that saying, love is patient, love is kind. Because Andrew, you're going to have to be very patient, waiting for Brandy to arrive. And Brandy, you've kind of gotten better at that since I've met you. But in all seriousness, though, Brandy, my friendship with you has always been, probably, or will always be, impactful things that has ever happened to me in my life. You've taught me to always see the positive side of things, always look for the good in people, always chase my dreams, and you've always been there for me for the good and the bad. And I've witnessed Andrew, who has an excellent name, by the way, witnessed you do the same and earn a spot in her life. And, you know, just through everything you've done, you guys have just grown together so well. Hospitality you guys have both shown me. You were in a spot in my life and one of my friends as well. So I just want to see you guys continue to love each other, continue to grow, and just be well. So with that, toast to you both. And following is one of our friends, Ryan.
Please don't clap. You don't have to clap. It's all right. So I was told not to drink and just read what I wrote. I drank. So I'm just going to read what I wrote. Wanted to start off by congratulating Brandy for being on time to her wedding. Happy. We're all happy we didn't have to wait 2 hours, which is our usual buffer for rain. We're off to the start. But yeah, again, as Andrew mentioned, we've been friends since high school, over a decade now, which is crazy. I hope you've gained as much from this friendship as I have throughout the years. Your selflessness is admirable. Your compassion for others is something our world needs a lot more of. And your success should be an inspiration to all. I've matured into the determined and caring person I am today in part due to this friendship. And I'm excited to continue to see our friendship grow. Peterman, you've been genuine, chivalrous, and honestly such a true gentleman since the day that I met you. I actually remember thinking after we met, Brandy and I had a conversation, I remember telling Brandy, don't mess this up. I liked you from the back. The moment we met, I liked you. And it was evident how much you cared about her and how perfect you were for each other then. And here we are today. I'm sure it's been such a long road, rough road. I'm sure Brandy would have won this a lot earlier. But this new journey you're about to embark on will be longer and tougher. But know that you will not be alone. God will be there for you. I will continue to be there for you. You have a room full of support that will be there for you. And we all look forward to seeing your marriage blossom for the many, many years to come. Cheers. Now I'm going to pass the mic off to Mark.
Married now, Peterman. Oh my God. I was nervous for a while. Before you came up, I was nervous. But you did come up tonight. All I have to say, you know, I don't have anything funny to say. I just have something very fatherly advice for you. And, you know, for the both of you. And I just want to start to say that God, you know, He created both of you different for a specific reason. When you come together, you complement each other, okay? And, you know, for a marriage to be successful, you have to understand one another. Okay, God commands you to dwell with your wife according to knowledge. You know, according to knowledge, you have to, 1 Peter 3:7. It's translated from the Greek. It means to seek, to know, to inquire, to investigate. You have to understand her, find out where she's coming from, you know, feel her, you know what I mean? And so you guys, you work together. It's going to be rough. There's going to be ups and downs. You guys can eat in this room. They'll tell you. You know, just starting out. And I want you to be successful. You know, I want you to do it God's way. It'll work out beautifully. I know it will. For that to work together, you know, you have to work together, you know. You know, Brandy has to be with you, you have to be with her, she follows your lead, you're the head, you're the husband, you're the provider, you're the protector. You know, you make that job easy for her, pleasant for her, you know, and you guys are doing good, you know. Brandy's so smart, so just blow me away, you know, just watching you grow over the years, you know, not being able to be here all the time, but, you know, I'm here when I can be, and I'll be there for you forever. And you two are going to be great. It's going to be wonderful. You know, just a little advice. Communication is key. It's common for a couple when they first start dating to date all the time. And, you know, after a while, communication can break down. You know, time passes, and you don't do that. You have to always date. Always date. Always be in love with her. Always choose her, and she'll choose you, and it'll be good. The good times and the bad, like your mom, it'll be good. It'll be beautiful, it'll be harmonious. And another important thing, you know, Ephesians 4:15, God says, speak the truth in love to each other all the time. You know, it's going to be rough times, it's going to be uncertain times, just, you know, we'll work through it. Each other, the truth, it'll be good. Y'all work it out. You know what I mean? Deep love. And the woman has to express herself. She has to express herself. She'll let you know. You know? What's that saying? Happy wife, happy life?
Yeah, we already heard it.
Yeah? All right. Just, you know, concentrate on prayer. You have to go forward in prayer. God will guide you. He will. And, you know, when she talks to you, just try to find out what's behind the words, what she's trying to get at. You know, it's her feelings, you know, it's her emotions she's trying to get at. Listen to her, understand her. You know, I know you're good. Effective communication. Well, if you're according to knowledge, you know, you're trying to seek out, trying to find out. And I'm so happy for you. And last but not least, love her. Love your wife. Love all else. Just love her. You know, God is with you, and I'm so happy that you came along here, and I'm so happy that you have put it in your life.
We are. Good evening, everyone. know me, my name is also Andrew. I'm very proud the second father of this beautiful bride. Teresa and I would like to begin by welcoming you all today and by saying thank you so much from all of us for taking the time and effort to join us in celebrating Brandy and Andrew's wedding. We know that many of you have traveled from long journeys to be here, and we hope that you have had a great time while visiting the wonderful scenic historic St. Augustine. Ladies and gentlemen, I should probably make you aware from the very start that I have lacked any real practical experience as a speaker. Having spent over 20 years of my life living in a house with three children, there have been few opportunities where I have been allowed to speak first, and even fewer opportunities when anyone is actually listening. So I hope you forgive me if the speech is not professional completely, and not even with some of those that were even said. And I've had far less Peterman punch in me than Alberto did at the shower at this point. So the lazy battles are completely unused still to warm me. Before I start, I have to say I'm totally blown away by wearing your dress. Yeah. It was the first day that I've gotten to see it, even though it was hanging in my closet for about 3 or 4 months. And she was absolutely stunning. I am one proud parent, you might as well notice. What can I say about the bridesmaids? Just gorgeous. And I suppose the guys cleaned up pretty well too. So I must admit they had a lot of help, but I give credit where it's due to the groom and the fashion police officer, Andrew. Good job. Now I believe the tradition dictates that a dad should share a few anecdotes about their daughter. I know Brandy is particularly nervous about this. I might say something next to in part of the speech. After all, it is part of a father's job description to embarrass their children. I'm particularly good at it. But you can relax, Brandy. I'll wait until we're out on the dance floor before I start that today, after a few more minutes. Looking back at the years, time flies by so quickly, and it doesn't seem that long ago since Brandy was learning to walk and hearing it today speaking or trying to at her wedding. Brandy is a wonderful daughter. She's a very caring person, has given us so much joy and happiness throughout the years, despite her expensive taste and everything. It's been an absolute joy for both your mother and I to watch a very talkative, extremely inquisitive, and often demanding little girl develop into a very beautiful, clever, compassionate, and extremely loving young lady. It was my absolute honor and privilege to help escort you down the aisle today. She's a perfect young lady who I'm proud to call my daughter, and I'm sure Andy is very proud of you if he would call her his wife. All through her life, she has brought joy to her mother and daughter. While not every day has been perfect, the love that we feel for her has been. Every father knows that one day that their child will find a partner, fly the nest, and get married. Every father also wishes her daughter the best of luck and worries about her finding the right man, one that will make her happy, treat her with respect, and look after her. I have no doubt that Andrew, she found that man. During the time that Teresa and I have known Andrew, we have come to realize how special he is to Brandy, and how much of a kind, caring, pleasant, genuinely nice man he is. And what a great son-in-law he will be. From the first day we met, he's been an absolute credit to you, Kim. And even though we never got the pleasure of knowing Victor, we feel like we had. His influence was easily noticeable and within Andrew from the very start. And that's how we got to know him. He was polite, he was well-mannered, and extremely likable young man. I know the tradition dictates that at this point that I'm supposed to welcome Andrew into the family. But the truth is, from day one, he's been like another son to us. By that I mean, when he stayed with us, he was very comfortable. He was comfortable enough to leave his clothes all over the guest bedroom. I'm kidding. About the clothes. The alcohol, not. As I said at the engagement party, Andy's been part of his family for years already. We're just fortunate enough to make an official announcement this day. Andy, I'm confident you will take care of Brandy. We honestly believe that she could not have found a better man. Now, I need your table. There are a couple more important than you are separate. And for the second one is for you, Andrew. Whenever you're wrong, admit it. Whenever you're right, shut up. Finally, I would like to propose a toast to the happy couple. I know that everyone here will want to join me in raising their glasses. There's a famous saying that goes, when children find true love, the parents have found true joy. Randy and Andrew, here's to your love and our joy from this day forward.
All right, everybody, please, one more time, raise your glasses in bright aroma. Get them up high, everybody. Get those glasses up really high. Cheers. Not this time, the bride and groom are about to do one of the most dangerous parts of the wedding. It is the cutting of the cake. Now, if you like. Thank you. to share a dance in the hallway with her brother father, Andrew, as well. Please have Andrew come out to the dance floor. Now for this special song that takes, I'll Be There by Josh Turner.
He picked up as you fell down. You piggyback right over a baby lamb. If a song to take you to sleep in the town, I'll be there. Need a coach or you need a fan.
All married couples that includes bride and groom, all all married couples out to the dance floor. Grab your significant other. Step on out here, young or old. Don't be shy. Come on out here. That's it. Step on out here. All married couples. Don't be afraid. All married couples, step out here to the dance floor. Young or old, there's plenty of room. Step over here. Might like shy away from the DJ on the other side. You can scoot in. Don't be afraid. Nobody's going to bite that hard. All right, everybody. Is this all my married couples? All right, let me explain to you what we're going to do. What we're going to do is called the anniversary dance. Okay, what the anniversary dance is I'm going to start a slow song. And then I'm going to call off a date. If you've been married less than that time frame, I need you to leave the dance floor. You're going to walk to the edge of the dance floor, and you're going to kind of stay at the edge of the dance floor around the dance floor. Okay? It's for a good reason. So once you move, we're going to have you stand on the dance floor around the dance floor. We're going to find out what couple has been married the longest. So what happened this time? I said start dancing. Big shot.
Sir, your turn.
What she said. Give a round of applause. 48 years. dance music. Come on, everybody, what's up with you? Billy Keys and Dance Floor is now with them.
So y'all, well, I hope you're ready for me. take the kids to sleep within the fire. I'll thank my lucky stars for the night. When you go, I'll see you back. I'm gonna get my hold of
thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Let's hold it right there, guys. And
why don't you give him the other one? Give him the other one, too.
Right there?
Oh. That doesn't matter. It doesn't matter.